Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We welcome you to our episode 5 of In Conversations. And the subject today is the story of the Tumri. For this, our special guest today is none other than Dhanashri Pandit Rai. And she again will be interviewed none other than Narendra Kasnur. So just sharing a little bit with you all about the Showcase Studio. We started this as a project to bring forward art forms and also artists basically who have accomplished and who have been pure to their genres of music, who have been pure to their art forms. And taking that forward, we did our first episode with the story of the Nagada, the second one with the story of Sufi gospel. The third one, we brought in the story of the violin. The fourth one was the story of Sufi Qawwali. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we have for you the story of Tumri. We have all been hearing Tumri for the longest time, but do we really know what Tumri is? When we hear it, do we know, is this the Tumri that we are listening to? And that's what Dhanashri ji is going to tell us today. And she's going to be singing a lot of our favorite ones. So over to you, Dhanashri ji, and to Naren. I will hand over the stage and I'm going to leave. And I'm looking forward to a lovely evening.
Thank you.
नजर नीची कर ली, नजर नीची कर ली तो हया बन गई, हो नजर तिरछी, नजर तिरछी कर ली तो अदा और नजर फेर ली तो कजा
क्या
बन गई है, हो तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने मारा, तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने मारा, तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने मारा, निगाहों ने मारा, अदाओं ने मारा, तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने मारा, निगाहों ने मारा, अदाओं ने मारा, तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने निगाहों ने मारा, निगाहों ने मारा, निगाहों ने मारा, अदाओं ने मारा, तेरी कटी हो भावे कमा, कमान पीले भौवे कमान नैना रसीले इन दोनों झूठे गवाह होने मारा इन दोनों झूठे गवाह होने मारा तेरी कटीली हाय निगाह होने मारा तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने मारा निगाहों ने मारा मारा तेरी कटीली तेरी कटीली तेरी कटीली निगाहों ने
Wow, fantastic. Welcome, Dhanashree ji.
Welcome, Naren. Lovely to chat with you.
Oh,
with
sure.
People watching on.
Yes, and welcome to all the viewers. And I hope you enjoy today's evening. It's going to be fantastic as you've already had the starting. so let's begin. I mean, what made you choose Thumri?
Yeah. Tell me.
Yeah, what made you choose Thumri? I mean, a lot of singers, they usually tend to sing khayal and classical. And
absolutely, because, Thumri. You know, good question, Naren, because we start with our, you know, full-fledged classical education, normally for voice training. And then we get so much lured by the rag and its development. There really is no scope to look anywhere else. We are told by all our gurus and everyone around us that, hey, this is going to take one lifetime, more than a lifetime to master. You're just a little drop in that whole ocean. So as it is the responsibility of doing khayal responsibly is weighing on us. And then to think of diverting is a big decision. But what happened in my case is, I think my classical gurus, even Pandit Firoz Dastur, started noticing that when I sing khayal, there is a little bit of decorative element which is exceeding what khayal needs, you know.
Okay.
I was adding a little more shringar, things like that. And, you know, once or twice he said, yes, you seem to have a bent for the semi-classical. But then I think what sealed my decision, yeah, you wanted to ask something?
No, you continue.
What sealed my decision was, you know, early morning at 8 o'clock, the radio used to have, these Thumris by the various legends. Just giving an example, what I would hear at 8 o'clock in the morning. करजवा लागे कटार कोयलिया songs like this of Begum Akhtar. Yes, or Girja Devi also they would play. Barsan lagi badariya rom jhum ke barsan lagi हाँ बरसन लागे हाँ बरसन लागे बदरी and you know all this okay another one Heera Devi Mishra for example Nanni had asked me specially to get in her song at some point आजा सवरिया तो है गरवाल गालों रस के भरे तोरे ने and I said what is this what is this gayaki what is this form I mean this is fantabulous and then I decided to have special training
okay.
and realized that trying to grapple with two forms, khayal and thumri, somewhere I have to make a choice.
So once you started learning thumri and following, pursuing it, what were the characteristics of the art form that you really felt was special, which made it very special?
Yeah, now it's a little difficult to suddenly break from the khayal circuit and enter the thumri circuit. You know, your voice projection of khayal is different. You know, the way in khayal you have to adhere to the rag. And here in thumri they say, hey, you know, go free. Take some variations. Show your imagination. So just since you asked about what gives thumri its characteristics, I have a little paper which I want to show you some, you know, points, which I call them as, you know, requirements for thumri singing.
Okay.
Or very simply, you can say what gives thumri its unique flavor or color.
So,
पहले कौन सी चीजें हैं जो आप में होनी चाहिए अगर ठुमरी सीखनी हो तो? The first thing I'll say is थोड़ा सा नखरा.
Okay.
नखरे के भी, you know, for example, you know, to give an example of nakra, jiya mora na lage beri balamwa, jiya mora na lage beri balamwa, jiya mora na lage. So this, a little bit of जो मिजाज होनी चाहिए, मिजाज कहते हैं तो ठुमरी के लिए यू नीड दैट नेचर. सो दिस वाज वन थिंग. द सेकंड थिंग इज यू नो नजाकत.
ओके.
नजाकत इज, आई मीन, इट्स अ उर्दू वर्ड. आई नो ऑल आर यू नो फाइंडिंग अ गुड एलिगेंस, लेट्स से एलिगेंस,
यू नो.
या आज मैं सजूंगी गुइयां बहुत जतन से, आज मैं सजूं. सो वी नीड नजाकत. देन वॉइस क्वालिटी, सिंस यू सेड द चेंज फ्रॉम खयाल टू ठुमरी. Something in that, I mean, I just learned this from listening to the greats, that wo yahan kaleje mein turant lagna chahiye, you know, when the voice comes out in thumri. If I were to sing in a khayal voice, baat nahi banegi. Let me take an example of a thumri in pilu, for example. If I were to sing, bhar bhar aayi mori akhiyan, and I sing it just in an open khayal voice, bhar bhar aayi mori akhiyan piya bin, it may not have as much effect as if I try to bring the thumri voice. Ha bhar bhar aayi mori akhiyan piya bin. If you could see the difference over there, bhari hui awaz. I often say that if you want to get this voice, I compare it to a naika.
Okay.
You know, who is pining for her beloved, he is not there. Her tears are welling up, and she's controlling those tears. When you control your tears, you get a tightness in the throat. And I feel then that voice that emerges, that kind of, for me, is the thumri voice.
Okay.
So that voice projection, and then along the way, I'm sure we'll discover a lot of other colors of thumri.
Sure. You talked about nazakat, and now that is something that a lot of it has to be, has to do with the evolution of thumri as such. So if you could just say how thumri evolved and what are the various stages that it went through. And
So we right away get into the early 19th century. When I do workshops, I tell the, you know, audience to imagine ke socho aap baithe ho darbar mein. Yeah. Is my voice coming good? Because sometimes I go back from the mic. You're hearing me clear?
Yeah.
So imagine we are sitting in the darbar of Nawab Wajid Ali Shah. It's the early 19th century. Yeah?
Now, one second. Tell me. Sorry, I'm cutting this here, but I'm getting messages saying that they can't hear you very clearly. So if you can just come closer to the mic.
Yeah. Okay. It's actually now very, very close to my lips.
No, now it's much better.
Much better? Okay. Yeah. So I say, imagine we are sitting in Wajid Ali Shah's court. Yeah. And Wajid Ali Shah was, he was a man who was not so interested in administration, matters of the state, but fun and frolic, indulging in the pleasures of life, you know. And he was a great poet, playwright, and a very talented man, Kathak dancer. He just filled the courts with music and dance. But the problem was there was a slight problem, that the existing music of the times was khayal and dhrupad. Now that kind of music did not entertain this Nawabi lifestyle. They wanted a music that straight away entertains and excites, something that is full of love and shringar. And that's why, to fulfill this need, Thumri started in the court of Wajid Ali Shah.
Okay.
Like a song of seduction, you can call it.
Yeah. Okay. A lot of, many people associate the Thumri with courtesans also.
Yeah. Because they were the women. Those were the women who were, singing. Those were the women who were extremely well-versed in the arts themselves. Music, dance, poetry. I mean, she was a woman of supreme grace. Okay. Just comparable to the Japanese geisha.
Okay.
Nurtured multiple artistic talents and even was called upon to teach tehzi to the sons of the noblemen. Kaise uthna hai, kaise baithna hai. So, yeah.
Okay. There was this link between Thumri and Kathak also, or dance.
Yeah, good question, because Thumri and Kathak, abhi Thumri shabd hi dekho.
Thumakna.
And ri, yeah. And even the thum is the sound of the ghungru, which immediately suggests that Thumri started as, an accompanying song to Kathak dance. Uske shabd mein hi ghungru ki awaaz hai. Or ri yane rijhana or to please.
Yeah.
And also, like you said, thumakna, the gate of a woman. So all that is. And the beautiful thing, Naren, is that it was a confluence of Hindu and Muslim culture. Because those songs of the northern plains went into the Mughal courts, the folk songs of the, North India, and that Hindu-Muslim element all got fused.
Okay.
The ustads, gave it their color, and that's why we have such a lovely hybrid music form.
Okay. Could you sing us something which brings out that relation between Thumri and...
Okay, the courtesan. Okay, sure. Do you want me to sing the Thumri Kathak connection or...
Yeah, Thumri Kathak connection.
Okay, then let's... You remember the opening scenes of Shataranj Ke Khiladi?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Yeah?
Where I know Thumri and Kathak, coming.
The famous... the absolutely famous Bhairavi song.
Yeah.
I'm going to hope that the sound gets well balanced. Let's hope you all hear it well in this Zoom zamana. Okay, everyone? Sound okay?
And then you will be able to.
Yes, it's absolutely
you
fine.
Continue.
It's wonderful. Yeah.
Okay, not too bad?
Yeah, it's fine. Kana
mein to se hari chodo sari kana mein to se hari छोड़ो सारे का नाम है तो सहारे छोड़ो सारे का नाम है तो सहारे छोड़ो सारे सुनो बिहारे नहीं तो मैं दूंगी गारे सुनो बिहारे नहीं तो मैं दूंगी गारे का नाम है तो सहारे छोड़ो सारे का नाम है तो सहारे रे छोड़ो सारे निस दिन छेड़ करत नहीं जान देत निस दिन छेड़ करत नहीं जान देत पन घट आए हो पन घट आए हो पन घट आए हो देखे सब नारी छोड़ो जी पट घूंघट न उलटे छोड़ो जी पट घूंघट न उलटे बिंदा सुनो न माने बिंदा सुनो न माने देखो दित गारे का नाम है तो सहारे छोड़ो सारे का नाम है तो सहारे का नाम है तो सहारे का नाम है तो सहारे छोड़ो हाँ छोड़ो सारे
Fantastic.
So the mic is on full and I'm yelling, so I'm hope the sound is coming okay. Nanni, how is the sound?
It's absolutely fine now. It's coming very well. Bas aap mic ke bilkul paas rahiye.
Ah, but so almost it's one, I mean, I'm touching my lips. Okay, Nanni, go on.
Okay, Thumri is such a...
If we can increase, I'll tell my person here to do that.
Thumri is such a vast subject, and you mentioned Shatranj ke Khiladi. So we'll talk a bit about the way Thumri has been used in films, and also later on go into the more into Bol Bana Thumri, for instance, and the various modes that have been expressed. And
So, you're talking now. You want me to talk a little bit about Thumri? Just one sec. My sound person is telling me to do something, yes?
Okay.
Yeah, now he's asking if this is better or... I think we are fine, Jeremy, we are fine. So, just wanted to tell you, there may be some songs which you don't even know are, Thumris. That's what Nanni was saying, that do tell them which are the Thumris because people may be hearing the songs. So, of course, Pakiza. Thaade Rahiyo, everyone knows that song. It's actually basically a Thumri, which was later on adapted and taken, you know. So it is Thaade Rahiyo, Thaade Rahiyo, More Shaam Ho, Thaade Rahiyo. This is one of the basic... the tunes of the original Thumri. Then of course, Mohe Pan Ghat Nand Lal. Everyone knows this from Mughal Azam. Uske shabd kuch alag the. Original Thumri ke shabd thode se alag the. You know? Mohe Pan Ghat Pe Nand Lal Gher Liyo Re Mohe Pan Ghat Pe हाया मोरी नाजुक बैया मरोर गयो रे मोहे पन घट पे
वो है घेर गयो
एंड देन दैट ब्यूटीफुल दादरा फ्रॉम काला पानी नजर लागे राजा तोरे बंगले पर नजर लागे राजा तोरे बंगले पर तो ये हो गई पुरानी फिल्में बट strangely enough, Thumri continues till today, and we get surprises like Jab We Met. Yeah, watching Jab We Met and suddenly Ustad Rashid Khan's, you know, आओगे जब तुम साजना अंगना फूल खिलेंगे. What a surprise that was.
Yeah, exactly.
Or then to, you know, to joke around a little bit, what about this? पनगट पे आके सैया मरोड़े बैया. Now, this is maybe not a Thumri raag, but it has the kind of lyrics that a Thumri has, you know, that student, what was that, student of the year, I think.
Yeah.
Bandit Queen. More saiya to hai pardes, main kya karu saavan ko, more saiya to hai pardes. So, Hamri Atariya was taken in Der Ishqiya.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah, it was. So we'll go back again to the earlier times when it was used as a classical. Yeah. They used Vilambit and in Bol Banao Thumri and slowly built it up as a classical combination.
Yeah, tell me.
If you can talk about Bol Banao Thumri and the other forms that were there at that point of time.
Yeah. So there was an era in Thumri, Naren, which was seated expression. We spoke about Thumri and Kathak being, I call them sister arts actually. So there was an era, you know, you've seen Pakiza and other films, Umrao Jaan, where the singer and dancer were both one.
Yeah.
And she would sit and emote, you know. So this was the style of the early Lucknow masters. She would sit and emote, sing and dance, and what a powerful medium of communication. Because the singer and dancer are both one. And sometimes thodi si moti rehti thi na dancer, she found it very convenient to sit on the ground and, you know, sit on the floor and do her expression. So, bet ke bhav or seated abhinay was a period, you know, in the history of Thumri. Later on, maybe it wasn't considered too sophisticated to, you know, for a woman to be emoting, you know, so suggestively on stage. So, you know, it kind of faded out. Plus, difficult to find singers and dancers equally good. I mean, Pandit Birju Maharaj, that kind of level we still get to see today doing seated abhinaya. Yeah. You wanted so a song at this point? Or?
Yeah, sure.
No, otherwise I want you to lead.
Okay, then we talk about Bol Banao Thumri, which was...
Yeah, the Bol Banao was actually later on.
Yeah, later on.
You know, what happened was that Thumri was moving slowly from this Kotha atmosphere because so many talented singers from Banaras, Rasoolan Bhai, Siddheshwari Devi, they had taken Thumri to a level where, you know, it was a stage form. It had developed to a high level. It was no longer this song of seduction to entertain. It was standing shoulder to shoulder with almost with Khayal Gayaki. So that was, the, I think, the zenith of Thumri's.
Okay.
When Thumri got its Vilambit, and I could sing one for you. Should I just get my tuning for that? And this was also, I think, Nanni had asked me to sing this one, Bairan Ho Gai Rain, the night becomes my enemy. The night is my enemy, Bairan Ho Gai Rain, Piya Bina. रोमे दिन रैन पल भर सुख न चैन बैरन बैरन हो गई रे सजनी बैरन हो गई रे पिया बिन सजनी बैरन हो short because there will be a lot of more questions coming.
Well, there is one request also. You've been singing a lot of Nanni's requests, and obviously she is very happy. So I'm putting in another request by Nanni.
Yeah,
which is Sanya Root Gaye.
Sanya Root Gaye. Okay, yeah. Sure.
So with a bit of description about the Thumri.
Description. Yeah. Well, I would connect Sanya Root Gaye very well to the Baith Ke Bhaav because this has great potential. Yeah, actually, maybe Thumri singers need to learn a little Baith Ke Bhaav, right? I think we should get training from a Kathak dancer to get more expression into our singing. Yes, let me get out the tuning for Sanya Root Gaye. It's a song that belongs to my guru, Shobha Guttu. We can sing it, but it's her song, truly. So I'm trying to sing as loud as I can and hope it's coming through. तो इसके पहले एक शेर सुन लेना सैया रूट गए के पहले हाँ क्या मजा बार बार मिलता है क्या मजा बार बार मिलता है अजी तुमको हमसे रूठ जाने में, रूठने में लगेंगी दो घड़ियां, रूठने में लगेंगी दो घड़ियां, उम्र कट जाएगी मनाने में।
क्या बात है।
सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए। शाम जाने लगे हो, शाम जाने जाने जाने, शाम जाने लगे मैं बुलाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए। सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही, सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही, सैया रूठ गए, सैया रूठ गए, हाँ मैं मनाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए। मेरे सुने मधुबन में बहार, मेरे सुने मधुबन में बहार आ गई, सुवन की धारा गई, अम्बुआ की डारी पे हो, अम्बुआ की डारी पे, अम्बुआ की डारी पे बरी कोयली गा गा के मुझको रुलाने लगी रे, सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही, सैया रूठ गए, सैया रूठ गए मैं मनाती रही रे, सैया रूठ गए, सैया रूठ गए रे, सैया रूठ गए।
वाह, फैंटास्टिक, दैट वाज वंडरफुल। नन्नी आल्सो सेज थैंक्स, शी इज जस्ट लेट मी व्हिच ब्रिंग्स अस टू द थिंग दैट वी बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट फॉर सम टाइम, लाइक सिंस वी दिस थिंग व्हिच इज द रोल ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन हमरी। Because in classical, in khayal, there is a lot of emphasis on the technical aspect. Ghazal, it's on the poetry. And so in Thumri, the bhava, the expression. So how does one, master that? How does one go approach that rather?
Yeah. Excellent question, Naren. I mean, you've got to the crux of the matter in that question.
Okay. You know?
Because it's the crux. Yeah. You know, look at Thumri. Look at the rag, you know, aadhar it has. It doesn't have tremendous aadhar of rag. We are using folk-based rags, you know, which don't have a very strong personality. So the rag element is very flexible and light in Thumri. Now come to the lyrics. It's very amusing, I'll say, that Munawar Ali Khan Saab, had, he had said, you know, about Thumri's lyrics, it's like a telegram, you know, it's so-and-so has come, so-and-so has gone away. He said, lagta hai ke, you know, it's a telegram. So the poetic element is very simplistic. Mere sahiyan nahi aaye, mera jiya jal raha hai. So imagine a form that neither has a very strong raag base, nor is the poetry like the poetry of, say, ghazal, where there's, you know, very solid poetry there.
Yeah.
So how does a form like Thumri get its expression? That's your question, I think.
Yeah.
So maybe I'll demonstrate by taking one line for you.
Sure.
And definitely show how we, you know, give bhav to this simple line.
Okay.
So once again, the line I'm taking is, my beloved hasn't come, my heart is burning.
Okay.
So suppose the Naika is first rendering it just with mild irritation. Mere saiya nahi aaye Ram, mera jiya jalaye. Mild irritation. Now worry, he's really not coming. मुरे सैया नहीं आए, मोरा जियरा जलाए. नाउ शी नो शी सिंगिंग विथ एंगर. मोरे सैया नहीं आए, मोरा जियरा जलाए. एंड देन डिस्पेयर, ही इज नॉट गोइंग टू कम. मोरे सैया नहीं आए, राम मोरे सैया नहीं आए, राम हो मोरा जियरा जलाए. सो आई एम हियरिंग दिस बैकग्राउंड साउंड, या सो दैट दैट्स व्हाट आई वुड से इज, यू नो, द वेरियस.
फैंटास्टिक.
आई जस्ट हश्ड अप द पीपल इन द ऑडियंस इन माय लिविंग रूम. ओके.
A lot of Thumris, they talk about Sanya, beloved, love. So is there anything, any other, I mean, like, can it be used for a spiritual mood or that kind of atheist?
Yeah, so I would say this is the cause of a debate, you know, about Thumri. I'm just bringing out the words written by some musicologist. He says, what is debatable in Thumri is the extent to which the devotional element exists beyond the purely erotic element.
Achha.
Some writers attest to the importance of bhakti, while some say that such apologists are merely attempting to provide a glossy spiritual justification to mundane eroticism.
Okay.
So this is what Thumri, what you could, Naren, speak about madhur bhakti in our all our arts, isn't it?
Okay. Yeah.
What would you say?
No, I don't. I basically, it's like, it's about, from what I've heard, like most Thumris revolve around the subject of love and longing and subjects like that.
Yeah.
But there is also, like, I mean, I've heard Kabir, this thing like Saya Nikas Kai and all, which is much
so more. That Kabir's daughter wrote that. Yeah. It was Kabir's daughter who wrote that. You know, it's actually a bhajan, but because it has the feel of a Thumri, it's been taken in the Thumri repertoire. Also, if you hear some of the, you know, Abdul Karim Khan Saab, even my Guru Pandit Firoz Dastu, the Kirana kind of pokar that would come in the Thumri, you know. Piya ke milane ki aas sarve din din jo banwaye पिया के मिलन के आस. Now all this gives you the feeling of that spiritual journey and the yearning. So there are thumris like that, Babul Mora, Sahiya Nikas Gaye. They will give you a feeling of elevation.
Okay, sure. The other subject that we'd like to talk about is thumri, the fusion with other genres how does that help, and how successful has it been infusing thumri with other genres?
Yeah, now I think all over now with Coke Studio and all that, you must have seen beautiful thumris, which have been taken and they've had a Western, setting to them. I think Savan Ki Ritu, I mean, there are numerous examples on the net, Coke Studio, where thumris have been taken. What about that lovely song from Fuso, I think it was? I'm trying to get it,
This will really father and uncle youth. Shafkat's father and uncle. Huh? Fusion.
Fusion.
But his father and uncle, Amanat Ali and his brother, they had sung it.
They had sung it. So, I mean, these are all showing how thumri is getting Western. And then I gave you an example before our program that I've been doing some work with Merlin D'Souza as well as some other, jazz artists. Because jazz and thumri have a lot in common. They both break boundaries. They both are spiritual. And they both fall in the semi-classical bracket. So, say I were to take a Raag Kirwani, for example. Let me just take Raag Kirwani for you. And of course, Narendra, there's no one more who knows jazz more than you.
Oh, no. I love jazz.
Yes. I'm just trying to get the right tuning here. Sorry for the time taken. Autumn leaves, it's autumn now. I'm going to sing you just a bit of Autumn Leaves in French, since I've trained in French for so long. I want to slip it in. C'est une chanson qui nous ressemble. Toi, tu m'aimais et je t'aimais. Nous vivions tous les deux ensemble. Moi qui t'aimais, toi qui m'aimais, mais la vie sépare ceux qui s'aiment tout doucement, sans faire de bruit, et la mer efface sur le sable les pas des amants. No, I won't stop singing it. So here you can get तोरे बिना मोहे चैन नहीं ब्रिज के नंद लाला ब्रिज के नंद लाला तोरे बिना मोहे चैन नहीं रे गम पद पगरे. So you can pick up thumris which have a little Western scale also in them and do amazing work.
Okay. Thank you. And we have actually so many more questions, but the thing. But we'll have a couple of more questions. One is about the languages used in thumri.
People would, maybe assume that thumri should have been in Hindi or thumri should have been in Urdu, given the fact that it was Wajid Ali Shah's court. But strangely enough, these are not the choice of languages. The choice is Brij Bhasha, Bhojpuri, Avadi, Khadi Boli, the dialects of, UP and neighboring states, because they have a softer feel to them. More vowels, sound sweeter, So those were the ones used in Thumri.
Okay. And there is a question from Vinodini Lulla, who asks, like, is Kajri a form of Thumri? And we also talked about the other thing, like Hori, Chaiti, Jhula.
Oh, yes. Kajri is very much a part of the Thumri genre. There's Kajri, which has the monsoon Thumris. There's Jhula, which shows the, you know, Radha Krishna on the swing. There is Hori, which shows the festival of Holi. So that all comes in your detailed Thumri, you know, module, where you will need a long Thumri module where you can give an example of a Hori, Kajri, Savan, Baramasa, so many folk forms which have become Thumris. Yes.
Okay. So, well, that was fantastic, and we come to a near close, actually. But before that, it was a wonderful session. There was so much that we learned, and there's so much more we can actually build upon from what we learned today. It was a wonderful talk, and there are a couple of more requests which which I've already told you about, and so if you can...
There must be some time that Nanni has planned as absolute final time.
you can carry on for me, for everybody.
No, but yeah, no, this is just an eye-opener. It's a window for everyone into Thumri. It's not... Obviously, you know, you're not going to be able to pack everything in this. But as long as they've been enchanted by the form you have, you know, that is an achievement.
Yeah. So,
command, Naren, your commands.
We're now looking forward to the... You've been doing all my requests, and I had to pop in to say that now can we have Naren's request?
Sure. What is it?
Okay, we can start with a bit of Babul Mora, and then...
Okay, so Babul Mora, I'll just yeah, come it out to you.
Yeah, and then, you know, the other one, like, is my favorite.
Yeah.
Starts with H.
Babul Mora was composed by Nawab Wajid Ali Shah himself. So we come full circle. When he was exiled in Calcutta by the British, he had to leave his beloved Lucknow. He wrote a beautiful sher before the Thumri also. Ho daro diwar par, daro diwar par, hasrat se nazar karte hain. Daro diwar par, hasrat se nazar karte hain. Ruksat hai ahle watan, hum to safar karte hain. Babul Mora, Babul Mora, Babul Mora, Babul Mora, Nehar Chhoto Hi Ja. चार कहार मिले मोरी डोलियां सजाए रे मोरा अपना बेगाना छूटो जाए बाबुल मोरा रे नहीं हर छूटो ही जाए. Just hummed out a little bit for you.
Sure. And now the finale.
Yes. What is the request for the finale? The one and Hamri, only?
Hamri Ataria.
Okay. Hamri Ataria, the evergreen, again, Dadra belonging, owned by Begum Akhtar. But we all can't resist singing it.
Yeah.
Here we go. Come up to my balcony, my beloved. Hamri atariya pe aaja re savariya. Dekha dekhi tanik hui jaye. And let's have a look at each other. Let's have a rendezvous. Nain mil jai hai, najar lar jai hai. Sara jhagda khatam hui jaye. Do you know that this Begum Akhtar sang this song on the occasion of the Simla Agreement? In 1972, I think it was. She was invited to sing this when Indira Gandhi and Mr. Bhutto was there. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto had come to sign the Simla Agreement and she had to sing something on the occasion. She got this song from a dhoban, you know, from one of the folk ladies, improvised on it and said, Sara jhagda khatam hui jaye. And I believe Mr. Bhutto has said ki aapne jis tarah gaya hai, lagta hai baat ban hi jayegi. And then that pact was signed. So that's the history of this song.
Interestingly, Begum Akhtar's birth anniversary was on the 7th of October. So we are like in the same week right
Yeah,
now.
We are in her aura as we sing. Yeah. ओ तुम्हारी याद आंसू बन के आई चश्मे वीरों में तुम्हारी याद आंसू बन के आई चश्मे वीरों जहे किस्मत के वीरानों में हो जहे किस्मत के वीरानों में बरसाते भी होती हैं हमरी अटरिया पे आ जा रे बलमवा हमरी अटरिया पे आओ सवरिया देखा देखी तनिक हुई जाए हमरी अटरिया पे हमरे अटरिया पे आ जा रे बलमवा देखा देखी तनिक हुई जाए नैन मिल जई है नजर लर जई है सारा झगड़ा खत्म हुई जाए हमरी अटरिया पे आ जा रे बलमवा तनिक हुई जाए हमरी अटरिया पे हम तुम है भोले आ को पाप कहते हैं अधर्मी, जग हसी है, जग हसी है, तुम ना हसियो, जग हसी है, तुम ना हसियो, तुम हसियो तो जुलम हुई जाए, हमरी अटरिया पे आ जा रे बलमुआ, देखा देखी तनिक हुई जाए, हमरी अटरिया पे तसव्वुर में चले आते हो, कुछ बातें भी होती हैं, शबे फुरकत भी होती है, शबे फुरकत भी होती है, मुलाकातें भी होती है, आओ बलम तुम, आओ बलम तुम हमरे द्वारे, सारा झगड़ा खत्म हुई जाए, हमरी अटरिया पे आ जा रे बलमवा, बलमवा देखा देखी तनिक हुई जाए, हमरी अटरिया पे, हमरी अटरिया पे, हमरी अटरिया पे हाय।
वाह, दैट वाज फैंटास्टिक,
थैंक यू,
वेलकम बैक नानी।
Thank you so much. This was just too beautiful.
Yes, it was. Absolutely.
I just hope technology was with us and there aren't too many complaints about voice,
you know,
fading.
The singing was so good that whatever little bit of technology issues that were there, I think we overcame those. And we have a very forgiving audience. And they know that we are doing this live. We do not want to go the pre-recorded route.
Yes.
So I have a very nice comment which I want to share with you. So glad our Chandika Kathak dance students here in Boston area have been able to access this beautiful event. And she said it's so important for the Kathak training for the students. So, So they're really very, very complimenting comments all throughout, of course. And all I can say is thank you.
I enjoyed this. It's always so wonderful, you know, first of all, having the three of you and then knowing that, you know, a large listener base is also listening. The live, nothing like the live feel, I think.
Yeah, I mean, a pre-recorded, I would have known what is coming and I would have lost the interest and the fun. But in this one, every moment, because despite so many conversations, there was something new every time you spoke. And when Naren came up with interesting points, and what many people have said is that I think we will have to do another whole session. We have spoken a lot, but I know with a reservoir like you, there is still a lot more to learn about Tumri.
So, I'm learning too, Nanni, as I listen to more and more of the, you know, greats. It's just so enlightening. I feel with each year, I may have learned just a little bit more. So.
No, but it's been beautiful. So thank you everyone for joining in. And I mean, of course, because we are fighting a technology war, not wanting to do pre-recorded, so there will always be some glitches for which we ask for forgiveness, but do bear with us. And so like every Sunday, next Sunday too, we promise you another one, which we're going to announce on Wednesday. Naren, a big thank you to you for this entire thing. And
I've enjoyed it. I've learned so much, I'm telling you, in the past 5 weeks. I mean, being a journalist, I have a way of thinking, but this is something else. Like, I mean, this is what I'm getting out of these sessions and talking to the musicians and understanding their thing. Because in interviews, we have a certain format, and I mean, in the print interviews, so which is very different from these kind of things where we actually go into the subject very deeply. So that is something that, and today's session was really, really, I mean, I enjoyed it so much. And all my favorite songs and Nanni's favorite songs also.
Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you. And I was like loving it, sitting backstage, listening to each of them. And the beauty is that we are technically supposed to be finishing at 7:15. And as always, we've gone to 7:40. But I have to say, we've got a fantastic audience. Nobody has left. And so thank you so much, Dhanashri ji. And for this, I have to say a big thank you to Sunita Bhuiya, if she's still there, because she's the one, I mean, I've known of you and I've known you for the longest time, but the connect that Sunita made for us, I think I can never thank her enough for that.
She's the absolute conduit to connecting us. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Sunita Bhuiya all the way.
All the way, absolutely. Totally respect that. And thank you so much. And can I just be a little greedy and say that I'm fading and signing out one line of your favorite Tumri? Just one line.
One line of my favorite Tumri. Yeah, I wish I had known a little before. All the Tumris are rushing into my mind right now. Okay, why not the evergreen one of Shobha Gurdu? The evergreen. Let me get it for you. Rangi sari gulabi chunariya re, rangi sari gulabi chunariya re, mohe mare najariya savariya re, mohe mare najariya savariya. ओ रंगी साड़ी गुलाबी चुनरिया रे, मोहे मारे नजरिया सवरिया. जाओ जी जाओ करो ना बतिया, जाओ जी जाओ 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 जी जाओ करो ना बतिया. ए जी बाली है हाँ हाँ, बाली है मोरी उमरिया रे, मोहे मारे नजरिया सवरिया.
Thank you, and thank you so much. And I'm sure the entire audience is probably clapping. So thank you so much. This has been such a beautiful evening. and a really memorable one for all of us, and so much learning, and it's just been too beautiful.